Well, fresh hope this morning that Australians could be travelling overseas by Christmas at the latest. However, what that looks like and exactly when remains up in the air.
Well, Minister Dan Tehan joins us now from Hamilton in Victoria. Good morning to you, Dan. Nice to see you this morning. Look, we'll get to international borders in a moment, but first, let's talk about those protesters yesterday in Melbourne. What's your reaction to that?
Oh, look, it was appalling behaviour. As a former Veterans Affairs Minister, to see that type of activity taking place at the Shrine of Remembrance, I thought was just deplorable. And not only do we have to make sure that we always respect those 102,000 Australians who have fallen fighting for our freedoms and our values, but we've also got to make sure that we never act in violence with lawlessness, and I thought the behaviour was absolutely deplorable.
Well, it was reported around the world as well, and look, eventually we're going to want tourists to come back here, and I think that doesn't reflect on the city as a whole, because the city as a whole is just wonderful the way they've dealt with a lot of things in the last year.
Absolutely, Carl. You're spot on, and it's a point I made on radio last night. That's the last thing that Melbourne needs at the moment, is footage like that being broadcast across the world. We want to be sending a message that not too long, we're going to be open again for international visitors, for people to come here to visit our wonderful, beautiful nation, to come and see places like the Grampians in Western Victoria. That's the message we want to be sending, and that's what Tourism Australia is working on at the moment, is sending those positive messages out there that our borders are going to be open before Christmas, and we want to make sure that we're welcoming people, and we need to be sending that message that we are a welcoming country.
So, I mean, that is big news, international borders open by Christmas. What is the plan? Are you opening to everywhere?
So the plan is to start with outbound travel. So for Australians travelling overseas, as long as we hit that 80% vaccination rate, which we're on target to meet by Christmas, and the individual state and territory is that 80% rate, then outbound travel opens up. And then what we put in place for inbound travel will be consistent with our travel bubbles. Obviously, with New Zealand, we're able to do that quarantine free, and it'd be great if we could get that up and running again. And then we're in discussions with the Pacific Islands, Singapore, Japan, South Korea, the US, the UK, on what those travel arrangements will look like. Hopefully, we'll be able to have home quarantine, we'll be able to limit the time of quarantine, and ultimately, quarantine free travel. Could require some testing. All those discussions are in place, but the key message for Australians is keep rolling up your sleeve, keep getting vaccinated, and we'll get those international borders open sooner rather than later.
Well, there's going to be a lot of excited people listening to you. There's a lot to work through, though, in just that answer there. Just with hotel, in regards to quarantine, even coming back to 7 days or even at home, that's going to vary according to different states by the looks of it, right?
Look, we'll work that through with the states and territories. We have a very important trial taking place in South Australia at the moment on home quarantine. New South Wales have indicated that they want to move to home quarantining as well. And as we keep rolling out these trials, the hope is also we could look at perhaps 7 days in home quarantine with testing either side, because the more we can limit that time in quarantine, obviously, the better for bringing returning Australians home, the better for international students to be able to return. So all that will be worked through with the states and territories.
I'm assuming that also means then that the caps on returning travellers is going to be eased, because there's no point if you've got all these Australians leaving and they can't get back in. Is that right?
That's right. The national plan that was agreed by all state and territory leaders and the Prime Minister sets that out too, that once we hit that 80% mark, those international caps get lifted. And can I say, our major aviation providers are already planning for that travel. So it's great to see that Qantas and Virgin are planning for those borders to open. So all the planning is taking place, and all we've got to do is just keep working towards hitting that 80% national vaccination rate.
Okay, in terms of some of the mechanics here as well, are you going to allow people from overseas to come in if they haven't been double vaxxed? Is there going to be a hard and fast rule there at the border?
Well, look, what we're seeing is that the airlines are saying that they want to see people who are vaccinated. That's why we've put the vaccination certification requirements in place. So it would seem that what the system is that's going to be in place is that it is going to require you to be vaccinated. Now, obviously, there will be some exceptions on medical grounds, etc., but countries are gearing up to see international travel for those who are doubly vaccinated. And that's why we're so keen to make sure that all Australians roll their sleeves up and get vaccinated, because when you want to travel overseas, everything we're seeing is that that's the way you're going to have to do it.
OK, a couple of quick questions. Look, I know in Queensland at the moment, the tourism sector in some parts is going pretty well. On the Gold Coast and all the way out through the Whitsundays is going pretty well, I understand. But in far north Queensland, it's been absolutely decimated. They're at 10% returns. I know the Queensland government is asking you for help. Are you going to give them any more help?
Absolutely. We want to work with the Queensland State Government to provide help and support for the tourism industry. And Carl, even on the Gold Coast, there's some of the larger theme parks are struggling. So I've been talking with the Queensland Tourism Minister over the last 4 or 5 days. I actually approached him to get a sense of what was going on there in Queensland. So it was, in fact, we reached out first to the Queensland State Government just to get a sense of whether we needed to provide more assistance, and I'm expecting us to get some very good news on that front. Okay. Hopefully today, if not today, tomorrow.
That's good. You don't want to tell us now?
I won't break it live on the Today Show this morning, mainly because we want to do it in partnership with the Queensland State Government, and these things should be announced together. So, and I want to sort of respect the spirit of that. But you've nearly got an exclusive this morning.
Nearly is not good enough. Hey, you do a terrific job, Dan. Thanks for your time today. And it looks like your sheep need shearing, so you better get to it as well.
Yes, I will. And just for everyone watching today, the Grampians and Western Victoria, great place to travel to when our domestic borders open up and we're free to travel. Western Victoria, great part of the world.
It sure is. Absolutely stunning.